your eyes on something. Or it's a little problem. Can I tell you that Peter didn't have no problem believing? He didn't have no problem moving. Mm-hmm. What he had a problem with was saying, focus. Keep your eyes on Jesus. Can I tell you, church, that your faith and your movement, mm-hmm. Oh yeah, it might get you out of the boat. But I think I need to tell you that if you want to stay out of that boat, you're going to have to stay focused. Amen. You're going to have to keep your eyes on Jesus.
Yes.
Peter showed us that it can be done. Peter showed us that if we have faith and we believe and we move on our faith, that there's things that's going to happen. That God's word is going to do what it says that it will do. And see, Peter started to focus when Jesus called on him. It was after he got out of the boat where he had the problem. See, when you get saved, it's one thing. It's when you, after you get saved,
that's right.
It's when you're going to have to focus on the Lord. I came to tell you, Lord, and stuff that when Peter was focusing, everything was fine. But then he heard something. And what did he hear? That was born in his ear. And it took him back away from the Lord. And the minute that he took his eyes off of the Lord, the minute he stopped focusing on his circumstances, the minute he started focusing on the problems that he had, the minute he took his mind and his heart off of Jesus, that's when he started to sink. Let me just tell you, more to start on this first Sunday in January of 2012, that I came to tell you, keep your eyes, keep your mind, focus on Christ. I don't know about you, but I'm getting out of this boat. I've been in it long enough. I came to tell you that I'm not going to be tired of 2012. The devil, you had me. You should have kept me. But now I know better. I'm moving forward. Keep your eyes. Focus on the Lord. Focus. Focus. Focus! Focus! Do we have anybody that's focused on the Lord? Come on, morning star! Come on, morning star! 2012, we are going to focus, we are going to believe, and we're going to move on God's blessing. Yeah! Yeah! That I will not have the same kind of year that I had in 2011. I'm determined when all of the breath that runs through me, all of the blood, that I'm going to do better. God said it. God promised it. I believe it. I'm moving on it. And I'm going to focus on it. Nothing. Nothing. Talk about me if you want to. Pick me down if you want to. Kick me if you want to. But my eyes is going to focus on the Lord. Because I know I might be down today. But sooner or later, I'm coming up. I'm coming up. I'm coming up. I'm getting out of the boat. I'm walking on dry land. That's what he meant. When he said, you can walk on water, you won't dry. Walk on fire, feet won't get burned. But you got to focus on him. Doors of the church is open. Might be somebody right now that wants to start this year off right. Somebody might want to give their life to Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
Tired of living the way that you've been living. If you know that you're not saved. If you know that you're not saved. And you want to be saved. This chair is for you. I wouldn't wait. You waited a whole other year. You're not promised to make it through this year. If you know that you're not saved, why don't you come on now? Come on now. Get out of the boat that's been holding you back. That boat that you've been in ain't took you nowhere. Once you get out of the boat, come on. If you know that you're backslidden and you want to make it right, perfect time to make it right. If I were you, I'd come on. Will it be one? Will it be one? Just one. Hallelujah. Give God a hand clap in this place. Come on, let's give God a hand clap in this place. Hallelujah. In this place. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. 2012, I got an opportunity. Might not make it, but at least I'm here today. Might not see tomorrow, but at least I see today. Might not get past today's hour, but at least I was here this morning. Thanks to the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Every time I get an opportunity to praise him and to thank him, I'm going to praise him and I'm going to thank him. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. God is good. As our officers come, lift up our I'm
and dope for you too. Our food ministry is still going on. And Pastor has started something called Remember to Tell Your Story. And I don't know if he, would you tell someone like that?
Yeah, I can tell them.
Okay. And as for our birthdays, we have Joshua Brown on the 12th of this month, Dwayne Thomas on the 18th of this month, Richard Lynn Sr. on the 20th of this month, Sister Mother Willow Ephraim on the 26th, and Tanya Moses on the 27th. So if you all see them this month, anytime. Just wish them a happy birthday.
Amen.
Any more announcements from the floor? Any visitors would like to stand? If not,
I just want Rose to say thank you.
Amen.
That was so good to me, and I went through crying, sitting, everything, but he stood right by my side.
Amen.
That's all I'm saying. He stood right by my side.
Yes.
Yeah. God stood right by my side. And I want to thank him this morning and asking him to be with me through this year.
Amen.
Make me strong in his name and his word.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Yeah, I want to, at the end of the service, you all, we're going to start this right after we do the benediction. What we will do is turn to each other and tell our story. Let me share this with you. God has always done something for you. He done something the day of, he done something last week, last year. But the last time that you were here, in between that time, God has done something for you. And somebody next to you need to hear that. And God is calling on us to be witnesses. And what a better way to become a witness.